Hi friends, good morning. I am happy to stand before you today to explain the concept of outstanding expense. Before that, I like to place a request before all of you. If you are watching my video for the first time, please be kind enough to activate the CC icon on this video. Then you will get the script of my presentation also. Then come to our topic. Today's topic is outstanding expense. If an expense remains unpaid at the end of the accounting year, such an expense is known as outstanding expense. Meaning of the word outstanding here is not yet paid. That means the expense not paid, but the firm has the obligation to pay. Such an expense is known as outstanding expense. As per the accrual system of accounting, if the firm has the obligation to pay in the current accounting year, it should be accounted for. Therefore, outstanding expenses should be accounted for. Let's see the accounting treatment of outstanding expense. Outstanding expense is a part of the total expenses of the firm. It should also be treated as a liability because the amount has not yet been paid. And now let us consider the adjusting journal entry of outstanding expense. In the case of outstanding expense, two affected accounts are 1. Expenses account, 2. Outstanding expenses account. Take the first account, expense account. When we account the outstanding expense, the total expense of the firm will increase. Rule here is increase of expense debited. Therefore, expense account should be debited. At the same time, outstanding expense is a liability. And here the rule is increase in liability credited. Therefore, outstanding expense is to be credited. Expense account is to be debited and outstanding expense account is to be credited. Therefore, the journal entry is expenses account debtor to outstanding expenses account. Here the expenses will go to the profit and loss account debit side, and at the same time, outstanding expenses will appear as a liability in the balance sheet. I shall give you an example. Salary of Mr. A has been paid at the rate of Rs. 200 per month for 11 months. In the accounting year, salary paid for 11 months at the rate of 200 per month. Total salary paid is 11 into 200, total 2200. Then salary of Rs. 200 for 1 month remains unpaid. This unpaid salary of 200 is known as outstanding salary. Here let us see the journal entries. When salary of Rs. 2200 for 11 months has been paid, the journal entry is salaries account debtor 2200 to cash account 2200. Therefore, salaries account debit side, we have to write to cash 2200. And adjusting journal entry for outstanding salary of Rs. 200 is salaries account debtor 200 to outstanding salaries account 200. Therefore, salaries account debit side, we have to write to outstanding salaries 200. The total salaries 2400 has been transferred to the profit and loss account, that is by profit and loss account 2400. This 2400 will appear at the debit side of the profit and loss account. See the profit and loss account debit side to salaries 2400. Here 2400 debited in the profit and loss account includes salary paid in cash 2200 plus outstanding salaries 200. Then take the outstanding salaries account. Adjusting general entry is salaries account debtor 200 to outstanding salaries account 200. Therefore, outstanding salaries account has been credited, that is by salaries 200. This outstanding salary is a liability and therefore it will appear at the liability side of the balance sheet. That is, see the balance sheet, outstanding salary is 200. Therefore, if outstanding salary is given in the problem as an adjustment, it should be taken in two places. One, in the profit and loss account debit side, that is added with the salary. Two, in the balance sheet liability side. Sometimes outstanding salary may be given in the trial balance. If it is given in the trial balance, it implies that an adjusting entry has already been passed. If an adjusting entry has already been passed, it gets automatically adjusted in the salaries account. Therefore, it need not again be added with the salaries. Therefore, no further adjustment is required with salaries. Therefore, if outstanding salaries is given in the trial balance, it should be taken only in one place, that is balance sheet liability side. This point is very, very important. I like to repeat it once again. If outstanding salaries is given in your problem as an adjustment or additional information, it should be taken in two places. One, profit and loss account debit side to be added with the salaries. Two, balance sheet liability side. But if it is given in the trial balance, it should be taken only in one place, that is balance sheet liability side. I hope all of you enjoyed this presentation. If you have any doubt, please be kind enough to note down it in the comment box. Please be kind enough to subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching. Bye. See you again.